This conference will now be recorded.
Yes, please respond. Last class we completed lambda expression, right? Interface with lambda expressions completed, right? Exactly. Because today class we'll start some new topic like string manipulations. The new topic, guys. If you go for the string manipulations, and the string manipulations we'll discuss about the three classes, four classes for total. The topic is what? String manipulations. If you go for the string manipulations, we'll discuss about the four classes: string classes, string buffer classes, string builder classes, string tokenizer class, guys. Basically, on the string manipulations means on the string we are doing some operations, right? Simply on the string we are doing some operations. We will discuss the four classes like string and string buffer and string builder and string tokenizer, right? Exactly. As you know, like previously, string is used to represent the group of characters. The string is used to represent group of characters or a character array enclosed in what double quotes, right? The string is used to represent what group of characters or character array. Group of characters or what character array enclosed within double quotes, right? Sorry, clear now. Good. You see this example, different ways you can create a string object, because string is having the different constructors to create an object basically. So there are different constructor ways. Because first case you can see is string str equal to Ratan. Directly I have the string str equal to Ratan. Directly I'm printing str, right? The first approach, guys. Second approach, I'm creating object using new keyword, string str1 equal to new string of what Ratan, right? A string str2 str equal str1 equal to new string of Ratan. So first case we are creating the string object without using new operator, guys. Here I didn't use the new operator. Second case, I'm creating string object by using new operator, right? The second case, I'm creating string object by using what? By using the new operator, right? One is without using new operator. Second one is what? By using new operator, right? Exactly, guys. The third case, you can see conversion of char array to the string format, guys. See, for example, I have a character array. Character array contains what? R, A, T, A, N, right? Like that. I'm bypassing the character array. Bypassing the character array, I'm creating the new string object, right? Guys, by passing the character array, we are creating like new string object, right? Exactly. And the fourth case, you can see character array only there. Again, RATAN character array is there. CH1 comma 2 comma 2, guys. 2 comma 2 means what? Starts from 2, 2 characters required. Okay, starts from 2 means what? Index always starts from 0, right? You guys can hear me. Index starts from what? 0. 0, 1, 2. It means this one, right? You'll get the output is like TA, right? Exactly. Because these two cases, by passing the character array contains a group of characters. By passing the character array, we are creating new string object, right? Guys, are it clear now? Good. Next one you can see, guys, byte array string is there. Byte array b equal to 65, 66, 67, like this. By passing the byte array, we are creating the string object, right? By passing the byte array, we are creating string object means then what happened, guys? Byte array contains 65, 66, right? String required the characters, right? Then what happened? The 65 corresponding Unicode value, like Unicode character. 65 means what the character is? Capital A, right? Yes. Yeah, 65 means what the character, capital A, right? So it will take the data like capital A, capital B, capital C, like that, right? Is that clear? Can please save this code in local disk E. The file is called test.java file. The file is called what? Test.java file. Yeah, then you can open the command prompt, guys. The local disk E CLS. How to run this code, guys? You Java. See, the file is called what? Test.java file. Right? Code is compiled fine. Code is definitely compiled fine. It's not a problem. So, Java, the class name is called class, guys. Here, test class, right? See, the first case for the output, guys. First case is written, second case is written. Third case also character array rather. Fourth case you can see guys starts from two characters. Then we got the output is TA, right? Next one is what? Byte array. Byte array means what? A B C D E F, right? That's A B C D E F, right? Last case is what? B one we are passing. 3, 2 means what? What the meaning of 3, 2, guys? Guys, what the meaning of 3, 2? 3, 2 means what? Starts from 3. How many characters? 2 characters, right? So starts from 3 means what, guys? 0, 1, 2, 3. 68, right? 68 and 69 it will take. 68, 69 means what? D and E, right? Capital D and what? Capital, right? Exactly. This is like different ways you can create a string object, right? Exactly. Because if you observe this example, first case we are creating string object. I'm using any new keyword here. Yes, I'm using any new keyword here. First
no,
case
sir.
You're creating string object, it told is a new keyword, right? Guys, what about second case? Second case you're creating string object by using new keyword, right? The second case you are creating string object by using which keyword here? New keyword, right?
Yeah.
Exactly. Remaining all cases we are using new keyword, but first case you are creating object without using a keyword by using new keyword, guys. Without using new keyword, exactly. Now we will see what is the difference between creation of string object without using new keyword and by using new keyword, right? What is the difference between these two approaches? Okay, good. See guys, finally we decided it is possible to create the string object in two ways. One is without using new operator. Without using new operator means string str equal return. That's it. Second is what, guys? By using new operator, right? Yeah, by using new operator means what, guys? String str equal to new string of what return, right? Yeah, string str equal to new string of what return, right? Exactly. That's the meaning, guys. And last case you can see this one you can see, guys. Creation of string object without using new operator. Yes, without using new operator, I'm creating string object like str1 equal Ratan, str2 equal to Durga, str3 equal to again Ratan, right? Again Ratan, right? Something like this. Ratan Durga Ratan. Okay, Ratan Durga Ratan means then what happened, guys? When you create a string object without using new operator, guys. When we create a string object without using new operator, the objects are created in one memory that is called a SCP memory, guys. Because where the objects are created, the objects are created in the SCP memory. SCP means what? String constant pool memory, guys. Okay, are you clear? When you create a string object without using new operator, the objects are created in SCP memory. SCP means what, guys? String constant pool memory, right? Exactly. Okay, good. Because in SCP memory, what happened, you know, first object directly Ratan is created, it's not a problem. But second object, guys, Durga, str2 is Durga. Before creation of second object, guys, is always checking, is there any previous object is available with the same content Durga or not? Guys, tell me, is there any previous object is available with the content Durga?
Yes. That is the content.
With any previous object is available with the content Durga? There is no previous object, right? Previous object only Ratan is there, right? Exactly. While creation of second object, guys, it is checking, is there any previous object is available with the content Durga or not? Now tell me, guys, is there any previous object is available with the content Durga? No, right?
No, sir. No.
If there is no previous object with the content Durga, then what happened, guys? Directly it will create the new object. Durga is created, right? Exactly. Before creation of third object, guys, what is the third object? Str3 is Ratan, right? Before creation of third object, is checking like, is there any previous object is available with the content Ratan or not? Tell me, guys. Is there any previous object is available with the content Ratan?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes means what happened, you know, it won't create the new object. It won't create the new object. The reference is pointing to str3 reference is pointing to existing object, guys. Is it clear now? So in SCP memory, it is always checking the previous objects, guys. If the previous object is not available, then new object will be created. If the previous object is not available, then new object will be created. If the previous object is available with the same content, then what happened, guys? The reference is pointing to. Then okay, the reference is pointing to what? Existing object, right? Exactly.
Same. Yes.
Yeah, that is called string constant pool memory, guys. Good. If you go double equal to operator, guys, in string manipulations, the string comparison, string is a class, right? The string comparison double equal to operator is always meant for reference comparison, guys. Because double equal to operator is always meant for which comparison here? A reference comparison, right? Exactly. Double equal to operator is always meant for reference comparison. That is a case str1 double equal to str2. If str1 double equal to str2, then what it returns, guys? It returns true or false now?
Returns false.
Because str1 is pointing to Ratan, str2 is pointing to Durga, then this dwarf falls, right? Str1 double equal to str3? Yes, str1 double equal to str3. These are both are pointing to both are pointing to same object, different objects.
Same object only.
Same object, yeah, that's what written in the true, right?
But the third case means it will compare the content, right, sir? When we are doing
actually, data types level, we have the int to float to string a boolean, is there, right?
Yes, sir.
How many data types in Java? 8 data types, right? Data types level 10 double equal 10 means true only. Okay, data type level, it is for which comparison? Data comparison only. But now here data types, so string is a class.
String is a class.
So string class level double equal meant for the reference comparisons, not for the data comparison. Okay. Okay, clear, Rani? What, Rani?
No, sir, actually, how it will be true, it means the pointing, it is going to the same references, that's why it is equal. When pointing is different, then it is false.
Exactly. One second, Rani. The next case, if you see, you'll get the clarity. First case, what happened, you know, maybe you're thinking like, sir, anyhow, str1, str3, both are same content, huh? That's what maybe it returns the true. You're thinking
exactly.
Like that.
Exactly.
She's thinking like that, it's fine. But second
even
case,
I am also thinking like that, sir.
I know, Sman, you always think like that only.
Yes, many students.
Fine. See, guys, this case here, I'm creating object by using which one new keyword, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. When you create the object by using new keyword, guys, without checking any previous object, guys, directly three objects will be created. Okay, it is three different objects. It won't check for any previous content. Directly three new objects will be created. Okay. If three new objects will be created, then three references are same reference, different references. Different references, right? Now tell me. Now str1 double equal to str3 means this case, if it is a data comparison, means expected true, right? Rani, now we can see. Now it is data comparison, reference comparison. Now definitely says like reference comparison, right? Even though str1, str3 data same, but it is pointing to same memory, different memories, two different memories, right?
Different.
That's what it returns for its output now. False is output. Small. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
I will show you practically this example, okay? You'll get the clarity.
Got it.
See, guys, if you show the practically, if I take this big example, this example is very, very important, guys. Try to understand the things. Clarity important, guys. Try to get the clarity. Anyway, you guys, without clarity, you never move forward. I know that, definitely. What is one? Without the clarity.
Yes, I will. Exactly. I will come.
Every student has to think like that. When you get the clarity, then only can move forward, right? Okay.
Ratan sir, I'm still confused. I mean, okay, we have two ways to do that, like string str1 equal to anu and then string str1 equal to new using new keyword. Okay,
Usman, after this example, maybe you'll get the more clarity. Let me complete this example. After this example, sir, still you have some confusion, let me know, okay? After
okay,
the
sir.
Test data. Good. Mm-hmm. Guys, here the test class contains one constructor. Constructor expecting which data, guys, here? String object, right? Guys, constructor expecting which object? String object, right? Exactly. Now see this code, guys. Test t1 equal new test of Ratan. Test t2 equal new test of Ratan. Okay? This case tell me, t1 dot equals of t2, guys. When I call the t1 dot equals of t2, first it will check the equals method in which class, guys, now? T1 dot equals of t2 means, first it will check the equals method in which class. Guys, tell me, first it will check the equals method in which class? It will check the
T1.
Equals method in the t1 class, right? T1 means what? Test class, right? Is a test class contains any equals method? Is a test class contains any equals method? No, right? No. Test class contains any equals method means there is no equals method, guys. Test class, there is no equals method. Then what happened, guys? It will check the parent class equals. What is the parent class equal? Tell me now.
Object.
Parent class equals is like object class, right? Object class equals. Parent class equals is like object class equals, guys. Here, which class equals executing means object class equals executing, basically. Guys, this case, which class equals executing? Object class equals executing, right? If object class equals executed, guys, it performs a reference comparison. Okay, as you said, like equals definitely belongs to object class. Object class equals, what it will do, guys? Reference comparison. Now tell me, even though T1, T2 content is Ratan Ratan only, but it is pointing to same object, two different objects, new keyword means?
Different objects.
Usman, same object, different objects.
Different objects.
Different object means what we expected output here?
False.
Expected output is a false, right? Exactly. As we discussed, like double equal to operator is always meant for which comparison?
Data.
Data. Reference comparison. Reference, memory. Double equality is always meant for reference comparison. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Double equality is always meant for reference comparison means T1 double equal T2. Reference is same reference, different references.
Same reference.
They are same reference, different new two different objects, right? This is T1 is pointed to this object, this T2 is pointed to this object, right?
So when you sir, can you please explain again the first one, T1 dot equals T2?
T1 dot equals means first it will check the equals equality you are checking. First it will check the equals method in which class I'm asking.
Test
first
class.
It will check that equals method in test class. Test class, do you have any equals method?
No.
There is no equals method in which class equals executed. Parent class
object
equals,
class.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah, parent means object class equals, right? Object
yes.
class equals, what is a behavior means? The behavior of the object class equals is a reference comparison. References it will check, okay?
Mm-hmm.
If it okay. is checking references means for T1, T2, both are pointing to same object, different objects.
Different objects.
That's what it returns the false.
Mm-hmm.
Even the double equal to also meant for which comparison? Reference comparison. This is also meant for reference comparison means what? Then T1,
false.
T2 point into same object, different object, different objects, right? This is also false, right? So then what the expected output guys here? So code is compiled fine. Yeah, code is compiled fine. Java the class is called test class. We got the output is false and false, right? Yeah, that is the first one.
So
finally, we
equal to
D2, single equal. Single equal for not for the comparison, right? It is for the assignment.
That
this is assigning the data. It won't return any data basically. It returns the hash code. So think of the comparison, guys. Doesn't this is the equality? Equality for just assignment data. Assign the data, right? Equal for just assignment, leave it. Good. The second case you tell me, you will get the clarity. Here str1 dot equals of str2. Now str1 dot equals of str2 means first it will check the equals method in which class?
String.
String class, right? Exactly. Guys, here string class equals is string class is overriding equals method. What I said basically equals is belongs to which class? Object class, right? Guys, equals is basically from object class. String class is overriding equals method. String class is overriding equals method means what? It is having its own behavior, right? Yes or no? String class is overriding equals method, guys. If string class is overriding equals method, string class equals what it will do, how it is overrided internally means for the data comparison. Guys, it is for which comparison? Data comparison. Data comparison means what, guys? str1 dot equals of str2. Now both data is same data, different data?
Same data.
Same data means it this line what the expected output now? True, right?
True.
We expect output is a true. Double equal is always meant for which comparison?
Reference comparison.
Then str1 double equal to str2 means? These are pointing to different reference. Same reference, right?
Same reference
means what? True, right? Exactly.
Yes,
so, first two lines we expect output is false. Next two lines we expect output is what? True, right? exactly java test class we got output first two lines false false next two lines what true true right exactly guys
Ratna sir can you
next line you'll get the clarity wait a second
no I got the clarity sir just I want you to tell to explain more about string constant pool string constant pool
no it's just like a memory area so it's a memory area okay. where the string object will be stored only string objects are goes to that pool actually that's it
okay
good
okay
yeah Usman this case what output tell me now these two lines for these two lines what are the explanation I given same explanation you can give for these two lines
false
yeah so these two lines explanation I will give you give me a second guys these two lines explanation I will give you to these two lines explanation Usman will give it these two lines explanation same format okay
okay
first str1 dot equals means first it will check the equals mean which class guys string class definitely string class is overriding the equals method basically equals from which class object class right string class is overriding equals method string class equals performs which comparison guys content comparison means what anu both are pointing both are same content right both are same content means returns what true right returns the true guys what about second case str1 double equal to str2 double equal to operator is always meant for reference comparison anyhow it is creating the string constant pool memory that's what it is pointing to same object or not str1 str2 pointing to same object means what it returns are true right it returns the true guys that's what these two lines are what true and true right exactly these two lines what is output tell me now
true first one is true and second one is false
yeah exactly the first one is a string class equals executed string class equals means performs which comparison guys first one is like string class equals means performs which comparison string class data. Equals performs the data comparison right because he's that guy string class is overriding data comparison means travia both content is same right both content is same means returns the both content is same means what returns the true right exactly because what is the second case here str1 double equal to str2 double equal meant for which comparison reference comparison if double equal meant for reference comparison s1 double equal to s2 s1 s2 you pointed to same object different objects sir
different object
because you are creating object by using new keyword if you create the object by using new keyword it's creating different objects right is it's creating different objects right exactly guys are you clear now that is the
yes.
that is information right
sir
tell me yaar
when we use equals method without creating the without using string data type then it is also used as reference comparison right
without string means where you will use
before first example test
what I am saying right yeah test is a class right for any class type maybe test class maybe string class maybe system class any class type double equal is meant for the reference comparison okay primitive types are there right byte short int long float double char boolean for those things double equal to operator meant for the content comparison I think Vandana are you clear now
no yeah. sir actually I was asking yeah. about that yes sir. I was asking that in first example t dot equals it is there not sir here
one,
equals method equals method also performs the reference comparison right sir
exactly
means if it is of from object class then dot equals performs reference comparison but when
yeah.
we use with string class then it is for content comparison
content because he is overriding string class is overriding that equals method
So only when we use within string class, then only the, it is used for. Okay. Sir. Thank
basically,
you.
Basically, which class or object class? Object class is for
yes,
the
sir.
Reference comparison. Okay. Good.
Okay.
This last case, you can see string buffer is there. String buffer, I'm taking the string buffer SB1 equal new string buffer of Naresh is there. Naresh is there. SB1 dot equals of SB2. SB1 dot equals of SB2 means what happened, guys? First, it will check the equals method which class, guys? You know? Guys, first it will check the equals method which class? String buffer class.
String buffer.
Unfortunately, string buffer class, there is no equals method, guys. String buffer class, there is no equals method. Now, Vidya, you tell me, string buffer class, I said there is no equals method. Then, which class equals executed, Vidya? Guys, then
object
which class,
class?
Object class equals executed. Object class equals performs which comparison? Reference comparison. Then in that case, SB1, SB2 point into same object, two different objects. Then definitely two different objects, right? Then definitely two different objects means what? Last line returns which value now? This line returns which value, guys? Guys, string buffer, there is no equals method. There is no equals method means what happened? It uses the parent class equals. Who is the parent of string buffer?
Object
class.
Object
class equals per which comparison? Reference comparison. Now SB1, SB2 point to same object, different object, sir.
Different object.
Different objects means what is
false.
Output now? It is the false, right? Exactly. Next line, last line output is what? Last line output? SB1
false.
Double equal to SB2. This is also false, right? So last two lines we expected output is what? False and false, right? Then code is compiled fine. Java the class is called what? Test class. We got the last two lines. You can check the output, guys. False and false, right? That is the information. False and false, right? Exactly. Guys, are you clear now?
Yes, sir.
That is called double equal to operator and what equals method. So finally decided. Equals method is present in which class, guys? Equals method is present in which class means object class. Performs which comparison? Reference comparison, right? Guys, equals method present in object class used for reference comparison. It returns which value? Returns the boolean value, right? Exactly. If two reference variables are pointing to same object, returns the true. Otherwise, what? Otherwise, false, right? Exactly. But second case, guys, here. What is second case? Here? String is the. Tell me, guys, what a second case. String is a child of object, right? Any class is a child class of object, right? So string is a child class of object, guys. String class is overriding equals method. Use it to perform which comparison, guys, here? Data comparison, right? If two objects are same, if two objects data is same, return the true, otherwise return the false. But string buffer class is a child class of object. It is not overriding equals method. It says like string buffer class, there is no equals method. String buffer class, there is no equals method means what happened, guys?
Yes.
Object class equals execute, right? Object class equals performs which comparison, reference comparison, right? Exactly, guys. Guys, this example tell me what's output for the first line. I think str1 is created in which memory? SCP memory, heap memory. SCP memory. STR2 is point creating stems, heap memory, SCP memory. First two are created in which memory, Usman? First two are created in the SCP memory.
Constant.
Is that one memory created or two memories are created?
One memory created.
One memory is created because it is always checking the previous object, any data is with the same content, any previous data is available or not available, right? It is always checking for the previous objects. Definitely the previous object is the same content is available. That's what happened, guys. Here. Then str1 and str2 is pointing to the same object, right? What about str3, guys? Str3 is a hello only, but it is created in the SCP memory, heap memory.
Heap memory,
right? So heap memory directly with the memory is with the data is what hello, right? Exactly. So str1, str2, which is created in the SCP memory, only one object is created, two different variables are there. What about this one, guys? Str3? Str3 equal new string of hello means what happened then? Str3 equal to, yeah, it created in the heap memory, right? Exactly, guys. Let's not tell me str1 double equal str2. True or false now? Yes,
oh.
str1 double equal str2. Usman.
Sir, true.
First one is a true. Second one?
Second one is false.
False, because str1 is pointing to SC memory. Str2
yes.
is pointing to heap memory. So two different memories completely. So it's a false, right? But next one gets str3, str3.
False.
Str2, str3, again false.
Again false, right? So what is the expected output here? So first thing is a true, next two ends are false and false, right? What about here, guys? Here I'm using equals method.
First one is true.
Mm.
Second one is also true, and third one is also true.
Because here string class equals, right? String class equals performs which comparison, content comparison, right?
Data comparison,
right? All the data is same data, different data.
Same data,
data. Same data, right? That's why it returns all returns true, right? Guys, all returns what? All returns are true or not? Exactly. All returns are true, right? See this output, guys. Once I think only first case you get the false. First one is true or false, guys? First one is a true, huh? Yeah, first one is a true.
First
true. True, false, false. Guys, what is the output now? True, false, false. Remaining three are the true, 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 right? This output, guys, true. True, false, false. Remaining three are what? True, 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 right? Because here equals method only for check for the data. Whether it is there in the heap memory, whether it is there in the SC memory, it's not a problem. It is only checking for the data. STR1 data, STR3 data, same or different data. Same data. Hello and hello is there, right? That's what this all three cases returns what? True, 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 right? Yes, three cases returns the true, 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 right? All are true, right?
Yes.
Guys, are clear now? Good. Yes, we'll go for one more last example. Compare to method versus equals method. Compare to is also important, guys. Just now we done the equals method. I'm talking about the string class equals method, guys. String class compare to method and equals method. Okay, string class equals method performs which comparison? Guys, okay, string class equals method performs which comparison?
Data comparison.
Data comparison, right? Exactly. If both data is same, means returns are true, otherwise return the false, right? Exactly. But compare to method belongs to string class, guys. String class compare to method comparing the two objects, and it returns the integer value as return value, guys. Guys, what is the return value? Integer value as a return value, right? Exactly. Sir, what is the integer value? What it returns exactly? Basically, if it is integer value, guys, both strings are equal. Both strings are equal means what? Return the zero, guys. Yes, both strings are equal means return the zero. Return value is zero. If the both strings are not equal, if it is not equal means it returns either positive value or what? Negative value, guys. Yes, if the both strings are not equal, it returns either positive value or what? Or negative value. When it returns positive and when it returns negative, that is a question. When it returns the positive and when it returns negative means, tell me guys, when it returns a positive and when it returns negative means?
First two characters of
the first string, first character Unicode value or Unicode value, and second string, first character Unicode value. Now tell me guys, first string Unicode value is bigger than second string first character, is smaller than second string first character?
R is bigger than A.
R is bigger than what? A, right? If R is bigger, first character, first string, first character, bigger value means it returns the positive, guys. It returns what? Positive. Okay. If the first string Unicode value is bigger than second string, then it returns a positive, right? Sir, what is the positive 17 it returns, guys? Why it is 17 means A code value is how much now? A code value is almost 97, right? R code value is assumed like 121, something like that. The difference between the 97 and 121 or 122, the difference is what? 17 is the difference, guys. Because you got the clarity, right? The difference you will get basically. But second case, we got the Anu and Ratan. Second case, you got the Anu and Ratan means then what happened now? Tell me. Anu is the first string, right? A is there. A code value is smaller than second string or bigger than second string?
Smaller.
Okay, smaller than second string or bigger than second string? Smaller than second string, right? Smaller than second string means what? It returns negative value, guys. Yes, smaller than second string returns which value here? Negative value, right? Exactly. Is it clear now? Yeah. Yes, last case, what the output tell me? Why it is negative means? Yes, here Ratan is there, here Ratna is there. Two different strings basically. Guys, this case, what is the point? Tell me. Ratan is there, Ratna is there, right? Two different strings are there. Then this case. It will check for the R. R is matched, right? A. It will go for the dictionary order, guys. Alphabetical order. R is matched means it will check for the A is matched, T is matched, then it will check for the A and N, right? Definitely A is smaller than N, right? A first string is smaller than second string means what? Returns positive or negative? Guys, returns the positive or negative? Definitely it returns the negative, right? Because see guys, if both strings are equal means return the zero. If the first string Unicode value is bigger than second string means positive. First string Unicode values are smaller than second string means what? Guys, smaller than second string means what? It returns negative, right? Exactly, guys. Smaller than second string means what? It returns negative, right? That's it, guys. Guys, this case, what is the output? Tell me once.
Ratan sir, if it is, can you go back to the previous example? Can you go back to the previous example, sir? Note section. Yes. So if it is like this, let's say the third one, ANU, ANU Ratan. Okay, ANU. Then the second one is ANU TN.
First case ANU, next one is what? ANU
TN.
TN.
And the reverse also.
Okay, good. Give me a second here. Let me try this code once, otherwise directly. Your system dot out dot print enough. What you're saying here? String message ANU or ANU dot tell me guys, ANU dot compare to of ANU dot compare to what is saying here? ANU
TN.
TN you are saying, right? Okay.
And reverse.
Can compile this code, guys. Definitely we're saying it message. Code is compiled fine. Java code executed fine. We got output is what? Minus two, right? It's taking that in which format, guys, yeah?
Negative format, but it is
it's
minus
the data. It's negative format, right? Why it is negative format means, see, for example, here ANU AN is matched, but here what the T here, which one is there? T is there. Here after ANU, it will take the new line character. It will take the new line character basically. Otherwise, reverse you can check it once. ANU TU simply like
TN,
here sir. AN. ANU TN,
yes.
ANU TN is there, right? Case you like ANU is there.
I think positive
maybe
2 should be there.
Yeah, the class is college class, guys. Here, test class, right? Exactly. We got the positive 2. See, for example, two more characters I will give. Here also, two more characters I can give. Okay, guys, can you please compile this code? You compile the code here. Java the class is called class here, test class.
Taking the character,
you got the clarity, right? If you here, if you add one more, two more characters here, two more characters. So, what we expected output now? Initially, two is there, next to four is there. Now, we expected six, right? First minus positive, negative six and the positive six.
Just taking number of characters.
It is taking number of characters, right? Exactly. Because AN is matched, here AN is matched. But first case returns negative. First case returns negative means why? Because negative means what? First string is the less values are there, right?
Less characters.
Less characters are there, right? First string is less characters are there. That's what here it is taking like a negative format. Here how many characters are there after that? Total six characters, right? That's what is taking the positive six. Here, which one is the more characters are there? First string itself, more characters are there. That is taking the positive character, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Good.
Sir.
Tell me,
sir. Sir, above example only. Sir, above example. Not this one. Last text.
Yeah, here. Tell me.
Yes, sir. So when we compare Ratan and Anu, then it will compare only first character, right? If it is different, then it will not match all the characters, just it will match first character and output the result.
Exactly.
So it will not check all the characters if two things are different.
No, no, it won't check for the characters. The first two characters are different means directly release the output.
Okay, thanks.
Guys, this case was output, I mean, no? This line, what is output, first line? Yeah, yes, first line, what is output now? False. False, false. What is the first line output? STR1, STR2, false. STR1, STR3? STR1, STR3, true. Next one?
False.
False. Because it will check the data by using cases to right? Cases yes. To means valid and the false, yes. Right? Next one?
True.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. This line? STR1, STR2. Mm-hmm. It seems like let me make here Durga. No, this case would open me. Durga, this is a compare to method. Compare to method means written as either 0, positive or negative.
Positive.
Okay, 0, positive. Now, STR1 value is bigger than second string or smaller than second string that we have to check.
Negative.
Hmm? Yeah, STR1 that compared of STR2 means STR1 is a smaller or bigger? STR1 bigger. Is the positive. Bigger, right? Yeah. Big means positive. STR1 here. STR1, STR3.
It's the same character.
Same is 0. Same is 0, right? Exactly. So next line here, STR2.STR1. STR2 is bigger or smaller than?
Negative.
Smaller.
STR2 is smaller. Negative. Smaller means what? Negative, right? Next one? Ratna and Ratna. Ratna and Ratna means what? RAT is matched, RAT is matched. It will check for the A and N. A and N means what? A is smaller, right? A is smaller means it turns negative. Next one. Okay, so the next line here. Compared to a Ratan here. Definitely both positive. Of cases, right? Cases to means what? It returns the what the value here?
False.
Why rare? Compared positive. To my rare, the integer value.
Not false, sir. Sir. Positive, I mean, whatever is bigger.
Which one is bigger here? Small is bigger, capital is bigger.
Smaller is bigger.
Yeah, definitely smaller is big. Smaller is bigger, right?
Okay, yeah.
Smaller, because small A starts from 97 onwards, right? Small capital A starts from 65. Definitely smaller is bigger, right? Smaller, bigger means what it is a positive. So next line, what is output now?
Compared
to ignore case, right? Compared to ignore case means what? We're ignoring this case, right? We're ignoring this case means what output case? Zero, right?
True.
Exactly.
Yeah, zero.
Guys, you can run this code and you try to see the output, right? Like that. This is a compare to method versus equals method, guys. Because today class bit important application level frequently use these all the methods you try to see. Okay. Good.
Ratan sir, why you have given Ratan after string args? Okay, it is just a name. Okay.
Good. Yes, next case you can see here, concatenation case, Ratan is there, soft is there, STR1 is Ratan, STR2 is a soft. We can concat the data two ways, guys. To concat the data, STR1.concat of STR2. STR1.concat of STR2 means it is concatting the data and return the result, right? Return the result is like Ratan soft, right? Guys, return the result like Ratan soft, right? Next one is what? Using plus operator, guys. Using plus operator means what? STR1 plus STR2. So, we can concat the data in string how many ways, guys? Here it is possible to concat the data in string two ways, right? Because it is possible to concat the string data in two ways, guys. What are the two ways? One is using concat method, second one is using plus operator, right? Exactly. Guys, that's all for the day one. So today class bit important. You try to check these all examples. For the first example, guys, different ways you can create a string object. And we found like two different ways are there without using new operator, by using new operator. Without using the operator means the objects are goes to which memory, guys? S heap memory. In S heap memory is always checking the previous object, guys. By using new operator means objects are goes to heap memory. Heap memory means directly objects should be created. Double equal to operator is always meant for which comparison, guys? Because double equal to operator is always meant for which comparison? A reference comparison. Equals memory belongs to which class? Equals memory is present in object class. performs such a comparison, reference comparison. What about string class, guys? String class is overriding, not overriding. String class is overriding equals method. String class is overriding equals method means string class is performs the content comparison. What is string buffer class? String buffer class, do you have equals method means no equals method in the string buffer. String buffer class is not overriding. It uses which class equals case, object class equals. Performs which comparison? Reference comparison, right? Exactly. And if you go for the compare to versus equals method case, equals method with respect to the string class, equals method is perform the content comparison, returns the boolean value. What is compare to method case? Compare to method is compare the two objects, returns such value case, returns a boolean value or integer value. Guys, return such value, boolean or integer. Return the integer value, right? Exactly. It's what the class knows link, productest.com/java9am, right? Exactly. The password for this one is what? Java is a password, right? Okay, good. Guys, today we done like new topic like string manipulations we started. And tomorrow also you'll see like string manipulations. This week, 5 days, we'll discuss about the string manipulations, 3 days, 2 days for upper classes. This week we will discuss two topics, guys. Today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, we'll go for the string manipulations, guys. Thursday, Friday, we'll think about the wrapper classes. This week schedule is a two.
So at the end, so Ratan sir, I think at the end of June we will be able to complete the course.
Definitely, we will see. The end of the June, yeah, definitely will complete. It's not a problem.
Including the holidays, if you take that.
Yeah, definitely.